Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Have a holly jolly Christmas. And when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Ho, ho, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you, kiss her once for me. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. Have a holly jolly Christmas, and in case you didn't hear, oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear voices singing, let's be jolly, deck the halls with boughs of holly. Christmas tree, have a happy holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way. Holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way. Rocking around the Christmas tree at the Christmas party hop. Mistletoe hung where you can see, every couple tries to stop. Rocking around the Christmas tree, let the Christmas spirit ring. Later we'll have some pumpkin pie and we'll do some caroling. You will get a sentimental feeling when you hear bowls of holly. Rocking around the Christmas tree, have a happy holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way.
Oh,
holiday. Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way.
It's in the singing of a street corner choir. It's going home and getting warm by the fire. It's true, wherever you find love, it feels like Christmas.
A cup of kindness that we share with another, a sweet reunion with a friend or a brother.
In all the places you find love, it feels like Christmas.
It is the season of the heart, a special time of caring. The ways of love make clear.
It is the season of the spirit. The message if we hear it is make it last all year.
It's in the giving of a gift to another, a pair of mittens that were made by your mother.
It's all the ways that we show love that feel like Christmas.
Upon a child that we'll always remember, it is the summer of the soul in December.
Yes, when you do your best for love, it feels like Christmas.
It is the season of the heart, a special time of caring. The ways of love made clear.
The season of the spirit, the message if we hear it, is make it last all year.
It's in the singing of a street corner choir. It's going home and getting warm by the fire. It's true, wherever you find love, it feels like Christmas. It's true, wherever you find love, it feels like Christmas. It feels like Christmas. It feels like Christmas.
Stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I've got to go away.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The evening has been
hoping that you'll
so very nice.
I'll hold your hands, they're just like
my mother. You start to worry. My father will be pacing the floor.
Listen to the fireplace.
Oh, really, I'd better scurry.
Beautiful, please don't worry.
Or maybe just a half a drink more.
Put some records on while I pour.
Neighbors might think,
baby, it's bad out there.
Hey, say, what's in this drink?
Cabs to be had out there.
I wish I knew how.
Eyes are like stars.
To break the spell. Say no, 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 no.
Mind if I move in?
At least
closer.
I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense in hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't.
But baby,
hold on,
it's cold outside. Simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has been.
I'm lucky that you
so nice and warm.
Look out the window at that
my
storm.
Sister will be suspicious.
Gosh, your lips look
my
delicious.
mother will be there at the door.
Waves upon a tropical shore.
My maiden.
I have three knitted objects that I want to talk about this evening. And they are all works in progress. So these are all knitted objects that are not complete. A couple of them have been a little, I wouldn't say languishing, but have been kind of on my needles for longer than I anticipated. And one of them I actually just started earlier this month and is a Christmas gift for my husband. Unfortunately, he kind of sees his gifts beforehand because they're almost always something that I've knitted. And, you know, it just is what it is these days. So, let's get into it. So, the first knitted object that I'm going to talk about is my husband's sweater. And it's in one of these amazing Christmas bags that I made from leftover Christmas fabric from the advent calendar that I made a couple of years ago or last year. And I made these this year and it brought me so much joy. I really love this Christmas scene. And it was all using scraps, so it just felt really like amazing. And this is a huge worsted weight sweater for a large man in it. So this is the Sanguine sweater, and I am forgetting exactly who the designer is. I will put that up on the screen, but this is the Sanguine sweater. It's an all over colorwork sweater, and I am knitting it out of Kelburn Woolen's Germantown, which is 100% North American wool. 220 yards per 100 grams. It's a worsted weight, and I used several different colors. So I used the natural color, and then I'll bring it a little bit closer. I have kind of a burnt, sort of a mustard yellow color, a burgundy. This is a dark blue, and then a teal. So I don't know if you can see that very well, but yeah, I really love it. I will say for me, I love colorwork knitting because I feel like it goes so quickly because all I want to do is like keep knitting. It just brings me so much joy. Yeah, it's absolutely amazing. I really, really love it. I think it's just like, the more you sit and wait, the more you're like, or the more you knit, it's just fun to see the design come. And so it just makes me knit really fast. So I have finished the entire body. And again, this is a worsted weight yarn. And so it went by fairly quickly, but I finished the entire body in a couple of weeks and have just cast on for the sleeve. Generally for me, for sleeves, I use like 12 inch and 9 inch circular needles and I just go round and round. What had happened here is that I actually ran out of yarn. This is the end of the cream yarn, and so I had to go back to Fancy Tiger Crafts and kind of re-up my yarn. But yeah, I really love it. It's been a great sweater. I think it's really cute. I think that Sean's gonna love it. It's got a lot of like 90s vibes that I think he'll really dig. I already know that he loves it, but I think it's gonna look really good on him. So yeah, I am going to work on this and make sure that I get it done before Christmas. I think that it's a totally reasonable goal. In general, for me, sleeves only take like a day or two. They're really fast. I find them to be like quite enjoyable because it's such a small circumference that I feel like they just go by really quickly for me. And particularly the second sleeve always goes by super fast. So the Sanguine sweater, absolutely love it. Sean is super stoked. I could see myself for sure making this for friends and stuff like that because with it being a worsted weight sweater, it just goes by so fast. And I feel like there's a lot of male friends that I have who would really enjoy it. I'll just show you. I also have his other Christmas gift in here, which are a pair of socks that I knit out of Mustache Yarns in their Han Solo colorway, which I love her yarns. I think the thing that I really love about Mustache Yarns are the fact that all of the are that all of the stripes are not the exact same width. So for a lot of self-striping yarn, and some of it is very beautiful, all of the stripes are exactly the same. And for me, I think that's fine, but I really like that that's not the way that she dyes her yarn. I think it just makes it so much more fun and interesting. And I'm sure it's a lot harder to do, but which is probably why other people don't do it, but I just think it's awesome. So yeah, this is just a general 3x1 rib, which generally when I knit fabric with self-striping yarns of some kind, I always do a 3x1 rib to make it sort of latch. It's not a good word. Like kind of just like suction onto your leg a little bit better, but also making it so that you can really see the stripe sequence really well. So yeah, these are just, they're already done. I just need to weave in the ends. And yeah, he's seen these all, so it's not that exciting. But for this sweater, it reminded me of kind of like the 80s and 90s. And it's also a sweater that I'm making for probably the person that I love most in this world. And so I wanted to choose a book that kind of took place in like the 80s, 90s time and was a love story. So, and also something that this book is like one of my top five favorite books of all time. Like I love this book. So this is Call Me By Your Name by Andre Aikman or Aisman. I'm not actually sure how to pronounce their last name. But this is a novel about two men who meet in Italy. So essentially Elio, one of the two main characters, his father is a professor, and every summer he houses a graduate student who comes and studies. Generally, I think it's like art history, or he's a historian of some kind. And he chooses someone to come to his house every year. And this year, this summer, he chooses a young man named Oliver to come and live with them in Italy. And oh my gosh, it is the most beautiful and heartbreaking and just gorgeous love story that I've ever read. It's so beautiful. Obviously, it deals a lot with them coming to terms with their sexuality and what this means for them. And at a time where it was not socially acceptable to have sex with people of your own gender, and it's just beautiful. I love the relationships. I love the buildup. I love the support that Elio and Oliver get. I love this book, and I also loved this movie with Timothée Chalamet and Armie Hammer. Like, it's incredible. All right, Call Me By Your Name. Later. The word, the voice, the attitude. I never heard anyone use later to say goodbye before. It sounded harsh, curt, and dismissive, spoken with the veiled indifference of people who may not care to see or hear from you again. It is the first thing I remember about him, and I can hear it still today, later. I shut my eyes, say the word, and I'm back in Italy, so many years ago, walking down the tree-lined driveway, watching him step out of the cab, billowy blue shirt, wide open collar, sunglasses, straw hat, skin everywhere. Suddenly, he's shaking my hand, handing me his backpack, removing his suitcase from the trunk of the cab, asking if my father is home. It might have started right there and then, the shirt, the rolled up sleeves, the rolled, rounded balls of his heels slipping in and out of his frayed espadrilles, eager to test the hot gravel path that led to our house, every stride already asking, which way to the beach? This summer's house guest, another bore. Then, almost without thinking and with his back already turned to the car, he waves the back of his free hand and utters a careless later to another passenger in the car, who has probably split the fare from the station. No name added, no jest to smooth out that ruffled leave taking nothing. His one word send off, brisk, bold, and blunted. Take your pick. He couldn't be bothered which. You watch, I thought. This is how he'll say goodbye to us when the time comes, with a gruff, slapdash later. Meanwhile, we'll have to put up with him for 6 long weeks. I was thoroughly intimidated, the unapproachable sort. I could grow to like him though, from rounded chin to rounded heel. Then, within days, I would learn to hate him. This, the very person whose photo on the application 4 months earlier had leapt out with promises of instant affinities. Ugh. It's so beautiful. I can't even like begin to talk about the things that this book made me feel. Like, it's just absolutely breathtakingly beautiful. Like, the prose are insane. It's just, everything about this book is insane. So yeah, Call Me By Your Name. This is one of my all-time favorite books. And today will just kind of be an all-time favorite books discussion. It is in fact an all-time favorite books discussion. I'm looking at the other knitted objects. So this is another one of my very favorite books. And this is a wonderful knitted object that I'm really enjoying, and I don't know why I stopped working on it. I think I might bring it up to Steamboat because I think it would be something really fun to work on. This is the Forest Berry Jacket by Fable Knitwear, and as you can see, it is just the beginning, so it's only been, I've only knitted a few inches of it, but I am knitting this out of Brooklyn Tweed Loft in the sweatshirt colorway, and I really love this. This is a absolutely beautiful yarn, and I've got a few skeins here. It's actually something where I don't have all of the skeins, but because it's like milled, I'm not that worried about it. But let me try to show you. So this is a bottom-up construction cardigan that has this really beautiful cable and bobble motif that runs down it. It's meant to be a very tight-fitting cropped cardigan. I think that I will probably knit it quite a bit longer. I don't want it to be long, but I think I'll knit it a little bit longer than is intended. And I love it. I think the one thing that's hard about this cardigan, and the reason why I think I stopped for a little while, is that it's required you to cable on the purl side, which for whatever reason, I really like to read my knitting, and that makes it easier for me to not really worry about what is going on in the pattern, because I just kind of look at my knitting and I know where to go. But when I'm on the purl side, I can't read my knitting, and so it requires me to pay a little bit more attention, which makes it a little bit more of a challenge. But I really love this. I think it's something that I will use a lot in my wardrobe. And I have been trying my hardest to make more cardigans. Cardigans are something that I really need. I have quite a few sweaters, and I just need more cardigans. I need more things to layer. I really like wearing a cardigan buttoned up and not having anything else underneath, like no dresses or anything like that. But I also like that you have the flexibility to unbutton it and wear it with like a dress or something like that. So with that, because it's a little bit more rustic and it has like a pop or a ruched sleeve and things like that, it felt a little bit old-timey to me. And so I wanted to talk about another classic, which I have talked about a lot, and this is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. This is a book that I read probably once every other year whenever I'm having a really hard time and just need a pick-me-up. It is so funny. The romance is so beautiful. I really hate the like insta-love romances and really love like hate-to-love romance tropes. And so like Pride and Prejudice is just like the best. It's like the beginning of hate-to-love, I feel like. So this follows the Bennet sisters and their trials and tribulations in England and them finding husbands. And it's just so much fun. And Mr. Darcy is like the hottest person ever, like the hottest character to ever be written. So yeah, I'm not gonna talk about this one too much because I feel like everybody knows what this book is about. And this is my really old copy. It has my old first name written in it, and it's something that I've written in so much. It's definitely like falling apart, and I would definitely love a like prettier, newer version of this, but I get really sentimental about books that I've like written in, and so I think I would probably never get rid of this. But chapter one. It is a truth universally acknowledged that a single man in possession of a good fortune must be in want of a wife. However, little known the feelings or views of such a man may be on his first entering a neighborhood. This truth is so well fixed in the minds of the surrounding families that he is considered as the rightful property of someone or other of their daughters. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. I'm sorry I don't read it that well, because I feel like whenever you're reading something this old, it does take me a little bit of time to like get into the writing style, because it is a little bit different, but it brings me so much joy. So yeah, Pride and Prejudice, literally amazing. And the last book, oh boy, this is really just like all of my favorites. So this is a little bit hard to show because it's both dark in color and set up in a very strange way. But this is The Daydreamer by Andrea Mowry. And this is an all over cabled sweater that also has this beautiful bobble detail. I really love it. This has just taken me a long time because it's an all over cabled sweater and it just takes a long time. Like, that's just the way it goes. But I really love it. I'm actually finished with the front and the back, and all I have to do now is the sleeves, which is kind of ironic because I was just literally just talking about how much sleeves are, how fast sleeves are for me. So maybe I should bring this up to Steamboat and finish it up there. I think it would be really fun to come back with like a bunch of new like finished sweaters that were just me finishing half finished things. So this might be something that I'll bring, because it will be, the sleeve does have this detail on it down the sleeve, and I think it's in reverse stockinette. So I think it is a lot of pearling, but I love this sweater. I think it's something that I will wear so much. I am knitting this in the Fiber Company Cumbria in the Derwinter colorway. And this is a mixture of Masham wool, merino, and mohair. So it's this really beautiful non-superwash yarn that I absolutely adore. It's a little bit hard to see the color because it's so dark right now, but it's this navy blue color that I am so into right now. So this is definitely on the docket, maybe something that I'll actually bring with me up to the mountains to try to finish. And that book, that sweater is so complex and has definitely been the sweater that has been on my needles the longest. And that's because it has this very intricate motif. That it's something that you really want to slow down and take your time with. And so with that, I decided to talk about one of my favorite and probably my number one favorite book of all time, which is another classic and something that you also have to slow down and take your time with, but the reward is astonishing. So this is East of Eden by John Steinbeck. And again, this is a copy that I've had for a really long time and I've reread multiple times. And so it's really just falling apart, but in the most beautiful way. East of Eden is a character-driven story about a family that moves to rural California and about the people that they meet there and the lives that are changed by meeting each other and learning and growing together. And it is just the most beautiful book that I've ever read. And I truly think like the most beautiful book that's like ever been written. It's like fucking beautiful. Again, this is definitely a character-driven story, and I've talked multiple times that I really do prefer character-driven stories with beautiful prose, and that is like how I would describe this book. So this is something that, you know, you really want to sit down and take your time with. And it's, oh my God, it's so good. Chapter one. The Salinas Valley in Northern California is a long, narrow swale between two ranges of mountains, and the Salinas River winds and twists up the center until it falls at last in a Monterey Bay. I remember my childhood names for grasses and secret flowers. I remember where a toad may live and what time the birds awaken in the summer and what trees and seasons smelled like, how people looked and walked and smelled even. The memory of odors is very rich. Oh, Steinbeck. Ay, ay, ay. All right. Well, that was a very deep and interesting night that I didn't honestly anticipate, but I hope that you are all doing well. I hope that you're taking care of yourself. All right. Bye.